heart disease, blindness and kidney disease, and diabetic retinopathy within 7 years of diagnosis in as many as 50% of children with diabetes. It developed problems with the eye. So it's not something to play around with. We want to make sure that we're not debilitated. All right, so now we have this Nancy.
I'm Nancy Bond, and that's spelled B as in boy, O-U-G-H, N as in Nancy.
I chose to participate in the diabetes study because I've had diabetes since 1996, and although I've worked very hard at controlling it, with the ADA diet, my A1C number had gone up to 8.3. And I also had two friends who went on kidney dialysis and lost their eyesight as a result of diabetes type 2. Just about the time I read the ad in the Washington Post about this study, and I thought it was time for me to take another step in the right direction of making sure this did not happen to me. I was assigned the vegan diet.
Tell us what that means.
Well, that means absolutely no animal products. And we eat four categories of food: fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and beans, peas, and lentils are where our proteins come from. Almost immediately upon starting this diet, I noticed that I felt better generally. And I could tell that my blood glucose numbers were dropping because, of course, I checked them a number of times a day. And in a period of 5 months, my number, my A1C number went from 8.3 to 6.4. I also lost all my joint pain. So I consider that an extra added bonus. And then immediately the weight started falling off. We were in the study for 18 months and I lost 48 pounds. See, for me on the study, I haven't found it that difficult to do. I have taken a lot of trips and I'm able to stay on the diet and travel at the same time. So it's not as difficult as a lot of people say to me, I don't know how you can do that. And just by a little planning ahead, it's very simple to do it. The study is over and we've had the final results and everything about my numbers look great across the board. So it's definitely something that I intend to continue to do.
Isn't that wonderful? So she participated in, remember the president that I showed you earlier, Dr. Barn? There they have, they invite people to come for a study. I wish they were closer, but they're all the way in Washington, D.C. And they put them on this for the length of time that she said, and this is what they eat. The fundamentals here, fruits, nuts, grains, and vegetables. This is what you had last time. It was just made with fruits, nuts, grains, or vegetables. I mean, we didn't have any fruits, but you know what I mean. Actually, there was tomato, tomato sauce, right? And pretty much, you can make so many things with that. You don't get bored with it. In fact, when we became vegetarian, my husband said, man, we're eating like better than a restaurant because you don't just eat beans and, I mean, steak and potatoes every night. You know, you have all kinds of variations. And so this is what was from the Creator. This is what we originally were meant to eat. He didn't give us, you know, teeth like the carnivores do. You know, our teeth aren't really meant to chew meat. We actually were meant to just eat this. So, doesn't that look lovely? Delicious. All right. So, how do we do it? We talked about what to eat and how to eat and when to eat and so on. You want to eat breakfast like a king. That's the adage. Eat a lot. Get a good breakfast. Get your day started really well. Actually, remember, what's a good thing to start your day off with? Remember? It wasn't food. Remember I told you how I did? Water. A cup or even up to 4 cups. Flush your system. Most times we're going to be dehydrated throughout the night because we're not drinking for all those hours. And hopefully you're getting to bed on time. And even as you're sitting here, keep drinking your water if you need to. And then, but eat a nice big breakfast, okay? You can have fruits. Well, we'll show you. You can have waffles, whole grain, and fruits, nuts, and grains. And I usually eat vegetables separate. I mean, you don't have to. This is just my suggestion. I tend to eat more of my fruits in the mornings with my breakfast, and then I tend to eat vegetable like at lunch, salad, you know. So however way you want to get that in to get your amount in. And my second one is, so eat breakfast like a king, lunch like a queen. I think usually people say lunch like a prince, But I know some princes, and they're going through growth spurt. They eat too much. Right? So I figured I'd put the lunch like a queen. But still eat a good amount of lunch. You know, make sure you're getting it. And then dinner, you can skip it or just eat something very simple, very light. You don't want to eat a big dinner. This, we talked about it last time. This is simply for demonstration purpose. I don't recommend eating a big meal in the evening. It's just because of the situation. To show you what to do. And we don't do that. I don't eat a big meal in the evening. Sometimes, most times I eat two meals a day, which is ideal. And by the way, it's best to eat 5 hours in between meals. So you let your stomach do all its digestion. Did you have a question for dinner? Okay, so she, for the purpose of recording, dinner is what she really likes, she said, and it's not good to eat it too late. So what would be a good dinner that would stay with you and not be too heavy? Not be starving. Okay, you know how I handle that? That's a good question. You know how I handle that? The food that I would normally have for dinner, I eat it at lunch. I go ahead and I eat a big dinner. I eat two big meals, is what I do. I eat a big breakfast and I eat a big lunch. And even though we have to go back to work after, I still go ahead and do it. I eat a big breakfast and a big lunch. And so I'm not hungry at dinner time. And if I am a little, then I'll eat toast, because bread digests, especially if you toast it, it digests faster. I'll have fruit, popcorn, not buttery, lightly salted oil, maybe with a little bit of oil. If you pop your own, or for my popcorn popper, I would just go ahead and pop it, then I'd put some olive oil or coconut oil, and then put the salt. Maybe if you want to season it with something else, shake it up real good, and that was it. But the point is simple. Something simple that's easy. All right, so something like that, yeah. But I found it really helped me when I switched my dinner to my lunch meal. In fact, the weight came off like that. I just wasn't hungry. Two meals just came right off. So, all right. I do eat later, except when I have to come into Burke Eyecare. And we're closed from 12 to 1, so I have to eat earlier. And so when I do come in, that's when I find that I need a third meal. I get, because I eat at 12 o'clock, and I'm hungry by 5, so, or 6, you know. But it's so late, so I don't want to eat a big meal and then go to bed. So I'll eat like a fruit, just what I said, fruit or popcorn or something. And then I'll go for a walk, because walking will help to digest the food a little bit faster. It's good to do that anyway. After each meal, if you can go for a walk, that'd be good, because it helps, it promotes digestion and it promotes the size. In fact, I had started gaining some weight back. I had become a little sedentary. I was eating, I didn't change, well, okay, I did change. I was eating a lot of corn chips, I must admit. I was, you know, the organic corn chips, I love it. And I was eating, and I was just gaining weight back, and I said, what's going on? Okay, maybe it's the over 40 syndrome. I'm going through change of life, or, you know, and I blamed it on that, but it was really too much corn chips and not enough extra. I just become more sedentary. So I made an effort to get back, and I'm still going. I'm about 5 pounds over what I would prefer, but I'm getting back. So I'm encouraging all of us to. She was saying exercise after the meal, but the doctor was saying to exercise before you eat breakfast to get the sugar level down. There's nothing wrong with doing, as far as I know, exercise before in the morning, because I sometimes do that. What I meant was after you eat, still go for a walk, because it promotes digestion, proper digestion. And I don't know about weight training, though. You might want to eat before you weight train. I wouldn't. But if you were just doing like aerobics or something, maybe. Make sure you drink water. Definitely drink water. All right, so obviously if you're sedentary, and I blame Burke Eyecare for my sedentary, by the way, because I was doing a lot of sitting down at the computer and all that. No, okay. But if you're sedentary, you want to watch your calories. You just don't want to eat, you know, you can't eat as much as these guys who are active, you know, all day long. Your body just doesn't need that much. They also need to drink more water. Also, you know, we all need water, but you see the balance, you just have to kind of watch and see what you're doing. And this is what this is a general rule of thumb. Two meals are better, but you know, 5 hours in between, 7, then maybe at 12 and at 5:30 or so. And then you don't want to eat just before bed. And see, that one's a little bit later. That's why it's good to skip that one if possible. But what I do, since you asked me about do I eat at 12, I usually finish my breakfast around 8 or 9, 8, 8:30, and then I eat my next meal about 2, and I'm good for the rest of the day. All right. And the non-GMO, we won't get into that tonight just because of time. But you want to make sure there's a lot of genetic modification going on, and unfortunately that can wreak havoc in your system. All right, so breakfast and weight loss. Tonight's breakfast. Breakfast promotes weight loss, by the way. So they did a study, and I think I need to wrap up soon so Franklin can do his demonstration. But he proposed that, Dr. Cup proposed that weight gain is the result of inappropriate timing of food intake in relation to the evening sleep time. I have proven this to be a fact. In fact, when I was getting back, trying to get back to my weight, I decided, let me go back to how I used to do things because I had slacked a little bit and I was eating a little bit later. Even though I was still eating 2 meals, I was eating at 4, you know. And I used to eat my second meal right at 2, I'd be done by 3, and that's it. And sure enough, I didn't diet. I just sort of went back to what I knew to be the key, get up and get going, and the weight started coming back off. So, oops, wrong direction. They don't want to eat too late. 595 overweight patients advised to stop eating snacks and eating and meals in the evenings. Last meal ideally at noon, but no later than 3. And by the way, that snack he's talking, that evening meal could be kind of considered a snack, right? If you're just having something light. But also, if you're doing, when you're eating your meals and you're eating properly, you don't get hungry and you have no need to snack in between your meals, okay? That promotes proper bowel movement as well. The snacking promotes constipation. All right, so they're advised to not to go to sleep until 8.5 hours after their meal, right? So if you finish at 3, you know, 8.5 hours, a good time, go sleep. Did not change what they ate. All they did was change the time that they ate it, didn't change what they ate. And all patients who followed the instructions lost weight. They ate only breakfast, 10 pounds of weight loss per month, ate breakfast, lunch, and snacks, 5 to 6 pounds per month, and the blood sugar level of the diabetic patients who lost 30 pounds or more were normalized. And this is from the book Proof Positive again. All right. Ecclesiastes 3:1 says, to everything there is a season and a time, every purpose under the heaven. So there's a time to eat and a time not to eat. Food eaten early in the day is digested and absorbed largely during the most active daytime hours. And therefore, the body is likely to get the most good from food eaten at breakfast and at the lunch meal. In contrast, food eaten at night shortly before going to bed is digested and absorbed largely during the period when the body needs it least and when the excess is likely to be deposited as fat. Not to mention, all your organs need rest. When I talk about rest, it's all your organs. Your stomach should not be working while you're sleeping. You're going to wake up groggy, may have nightmares, wake up groggy and all that. That is real. So it's good not to, and then it's just going to deposit it as fat. So that was a good question. Why should we eat vegetarian? Why should we? Because in Genesis 1:29, God said, behold, I have given you every herb-bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit of the tree-yielding seed. To you it shall be for meat. This word meat here means food. That's your food. And so as we close tonight, I have one more video to show you before Franklin demonstrates. Is I want to challenge all of you. I want to challenge you for a month. Can we do that? You see how they did the challenge and they lost weight? I'd like to challenge you. I'd like you guys, if you want to be a part of the challenge, is to kind of give me an idea of some of the foods you like to eat, and you can either give it to me before you leave tonight or take some time, just drop it by Burke Eyecare. And for 1 month, we're going to see, for those who want to lose weight or if those who want to try living a vegetarian lifestyle for a month, at the end of the month, when we come back for the next class, we'll just see how everybody did, like how that lady did. You understand? If you have any questions, Talk to me later. But look at this, what this doctor, I think he's in Texas. Look at what he's doing.
First, in HD, this is 13 Eyewitness News Tonight.
A Houston doctor claims he can cure certain diseases just by telling you what kinds of foods to eat. Does his four-week plan work? Still ahead, we put it to the test.
A few weeks ago, we told you about a boot camp run by a Houston doctor to help people overcome health issues like diabetes and high cholesterol by simply changing what they eat. But does that four-week-long program really work?
Well, we decided to follow two people through the process to find out. Health Check reporter Christy Myers takes a closer look.
Doug Pritchard decided it was time to do something after seeing our story on Dr. Baxter Montgomery's wellness boot camp.
My kidney doctor told me that if I don't get things taken care of, that I'm going to wind up on dialysis.
He'd gotten so heavy, 365 pounds, he couldn't walk without a cane. And his health had taken a turn for the worse.
I'm on three different types of insulin. I'm on a total of 17 different medications because I have heart disease. I've got uncontrolled diabetes, uncontrolled hypertension.
Julia Johnson has a similar story.
Because I have diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol. And when I heard on that new article that I could get off of my medicines, that was my motivation.
Both Julia and Doug were determined to improve their health with the help of this four-week boot camp. After 1 week, Julia has already lost 10 pounds.
Excited. I'm so excited and I'm so happy.
More importantly, her blood sugar level improved and so did her energy. Doug's first week weight loss was a whopping 17 pounds. He says things are already changing.
This morning my blood sugar was 79, which normally my blood sugar is 220 in the morning.
Wow.
And I've had to cut back a lot on my insulin.
At home, their routines have changed. No more steaks and fast food, but healthy smoothies and salads. And by week three, new challenges for Julia.
And I've learned when other people have food, I just remove myself from the situation.
And new converts for Doug.
All three of my doctors have seen me in the last week are just totally amazed of the difference that's made in me.
Dr. Montgomery says the plant-based diet program is the reason why.
Your body will heal itself when properly nourished. And also, when improperly nourished, the body will continue to deteriorate despite the number of medications you're on.
Week four brings a field trip, and Dr. Montgomery takes the class to a grocery store to learn how to make healthy food choices.
Obviously, you want to spend most of your time in the produce section.
The two-hour walking tour includes stops on almost every aisle, highlighting what's good and bad for the new eating plan. And at the end of 4 weeks, Julia has lost 19 pounds. She's gotten off one diabetes pill and cut another in half.
For 1 month, I did it. I can do anything now.
For Doug, it's an amazing 44-pound loss in 1 month. Plus, he's down from 17 medicines to 13. And he's gone from feeling his days were numbered to this.
I feel fantastic. I usually walk with a cane. I'm not using my cane. I can't climb those stairs before. I can climb them now. Just everything is, my complexion, everything has gotten better. I feel like a new person.
Christy Myers, 13 Health Check.
Are you guys inspired? Is that good? It's inspiring. I mean, it's, even if you don't have diabetes, just, you know, the cancer is on the rise. There's so many, you know, there's high blood pressure. So many things to consider. So if you're interested in doing the challenge, she's going to give me a list of things that she likes to eat, and then we're going to try to do some substitution. And if you would prefer, if there's a, I like what he did by going to the grocery store and seeing. Yeah, I think it wouldn't be a bad idea. If you want to, yeah, I think we can do that if we just go ahead and put it on that contact sheet, because we have a sheet. If you want us to let you know about the other programs, the other classes, you can put that on there that you'd like to be a part of the field trip, and then we will plan one. So, all right, that's it for me. So today, since breakfast is one of the most important meals, we decided to do breakfast. And so you'll see in your recipe that we make simple waffles. We did. Franklin is a bachelor. And he likes to talk about his bachelor-friendly foods. So he has a very simple, the first recipe there, very simple. Everybody can do that. What I did, I have young people, and I have a husband that doesn't want to lose weight. He wants to make sure that I'm giving him enough calories. So I did another waffle where I amended, you know, what do you call it when you put extra stuff in there? What do they call that? No, not supplement. Enrich. I enriched it. So I enriched the waffle recipe. And so you see, I have a whole lot more ingredients, but it's okay. As long as you're, you know, these are all okay, even for diabetics. But for those who may want to follow a healthy lifestyle but don't want to lose, like, a lot of weight, those are, you know, Dylan goes to the gym and he's trying, you know, he probably doesn't want to get too thin. So there's an option for you. As far as the fruit sauce goes, I didn't put in here, I meant to, another half a cup of water. So if you don't, it'll be a little bit too sweet. The fruit sauce at the bottom here. Just put a half a cup of water. All right, so I'll turn the program over to Franklin. You'll get to see a quick demonstration, and then we'll get to taste, and then we'll be finished.
Actually, I don't know if you know this, but Esther has a health food store. And so I go there sometimes, to the health food store in Grove. She's the only health food store, so you want to go to a health food store in Grove, you have to see Esther. I also wanted to say that I wanted to show some pictures real quick of what we do. We do the world's easiest, crowd-pleasing, bachelor-friendly recipe. I say it's the world famous, because if you go to YouTube and you type in opensourcevegan.com, you have to do that on YouTube, and you will see that this a video for this waffles has gotten 26,000 views. What we have done at my church is we get to do sometimes a waffle breakfast. So let's say that you don't want to cook a lot or whatever, but you still want to be kind of fancy. Just do the world's easiest, crowd-pleasing, bachelor-friendly, kid-friendly recipe. And then get everybody else to do something like a potluck, where they will bring other things. Maybe they'll bring the soy whipped cream, they'll bring the maple syrup, they'll bring the almond butter, or Earth Balance butter, or something like that. You can go on to the next slide. Okay, or the scrambled tofu, the soy, I forgot what that was, the fruit sauce, and we had the vegan sausages that were homemade. That was really nice. Keep on going, please. And then you can see that you can also have people bring maybe applesauce, and maybe they might want to bring something else. Like bananas and things like that. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna do four ingredients, and we're using this waffle iron. Now, I went to the Grove Walmart, and I did not like any of the waffle irons, okay? Because as bachelors, we wanna save some time, you know? I don't know who I'm talking to. I don't think I'm talking to anybody. I'm talking to myself. As bachelorettes, some people wanna save time, you know? So, or married people or whatever, we don't wanna just be in the kitchen and cooking, right? So why get a Belgian waffle iron that only can do one? Why don't you get a double flip? So you see this, it flips like that, and it flips again right there. So it does two. And so why get one when this recipe does four at a time? So what's good to do is you can get this Belgian double flip waffle iron on from Amazon.com and get two of them. Okay, so that means that in about 10 minutes or less, you're having four waffles done. Okay, so you can actually do the waffles and the fruit sauce and finish that in 30 minutes or less. For a family of four, you can have 12 waffles plus fruit sauce in 30 minutes or less. Yes?
How do they freeze?
They freeze good.
When they're thawed?
Well, the thing is, you can freeze them. They do stick together a little bit, but you know what you do? You get a knife here, and you separate them. So that's what you do. And, yes?
Could you not freeze it in parchment paper?
I think you can use parchment paper. I've not experimented with that, but then that's more of a refined way of doing it. But
that's a
refined way of doing things. Some people just, you know, put the thing in the plastic and just go from there. All right, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and do this recipe instead of just talking about it. And like I said, I only brought this here. One, I have three of these. But I'm saying for a family of four, is at least good to have two, okay, at the minimum, two double flip waffles, not two, you know, that are going to make two at a time. You know, if you got two waffles and make two at a time, that's a waste of time, in my opinion. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put the water in here, and notice I don't have a measuring cup for the water, because why do you need that when it's right here on the Oster? So I'm going to just kind of guesstimate a little bit, 2.5 cups. And if I put too little water in, I just put a little bit more in. All right, and so I did that. And this is already pre-measured here. This is 3 cups of oats. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. Now, if you don't put the oats all the way real fast in there, then it's going to, the oats absorb the water. So this will get thick fast. So it's just easy to do it really quick. So I'm going to now put two.
The salt.
Yeah, I'm going to put 2 bananas. Thank you for reminding me about that. But I'm going to put 2 bananas in here as well. And then I'm going to put, then I'm going to put 1 teaspoon of salt in here. So again, that was 2.5 cups of water, 3 cups of oats, 2 bananas, and now I'm going to put, oh, okay. I have to measure this.
No, it's a teaspoon.
This is a teaspoon? Okay. All right, so I'm going to throw that teaspoon in there just like that, and then I'm going to try to blend this. Now, this looks like it might need a little bit more water, and it's okay. If it needs more water, then that's fine. Now, the thing is, can someone plug that in, please?
Is that
I forgot about that. Oats? It doesn't matter. I thought it did at one point. I thought that it mattered if it was quick or if it was rolled. But I've tried this with quick and rolled, and guess what? It blends the same way. And so it'll be okay either way.
Health-wise,
okay.
Does it matter?
What do you say?
Health-wise, does it matter?
Dr. C, health-wise, does it matter?
Good question. So, the less processed is always better. I do both. I do either one. And I think even if it matters, it's not negligible.
Okay, Esther, go ahead.
So do you think that the let's say the fatter oats would have more fiber and more protein than the thinner ones?
Well, it just said it per cup. So okay. I guess it's how much you can get in a cup.
Okay.
You know, so
is
all right.
This the waffle mix?
Yeah, he's doing that.
Okay, so I'm about to do that right now. Now, like I said, it might need just a little bit more water. I'm gonna try that. All right, I'm going to pour just a little bit more water in here, just like that, and try to blend this. Now, I don't have a Vitamix. Now, some people do. They have like the Vitamix, or they have the what's the other one? The BlendTec.
Remember the Vitamix that we had
last
time? Powerful.
But I just want to get something from Walmart that's cheap. So. So what you can't see right now, well, you can see that, but what you can't see right now is it kind of has like, it kind of looks like a little tornado. You just want it to be blended thoroughly. It doesn't take that long to blend. I think this is pretty good. Now, if the nice thing about the Vitamixes and things like that is it'll blend a little bit more thoroughly than this, but it's going to still work either way. So I already sprayed. I used the olive oil spray. You know, I got this from Walmart, the olive oil no stick spray. And then what I'm going to do is put this batter into the waffle iron. Now, I just didn't know about the power. I would have brought 2 waffle irons here, but I just didn't want to like short the power. So I am wasting time now because I can do this in one scoop. So I'm just going to kind of pour that in there. And I don't have a specific formula. You just kind of pour it in there until you think it's not going to spill out. And if it spills out, it's okay. You just cut it up. And so the thing is, the oats kind of get thick after a while, so there's no set formula. Sometimes it's more liquidy than it's sometimes it's a little bit more liquidy. And so that's why I don't have a formula. But that's it. You just wait for 6 to 8 minutes, and then it will be done. So can we go ahead and show the final product? Can we like take the cover off the waffles? We don't have to wait, right?
We have the waffle, and I did bring maple syrup for those who, if you don't want to, that's fine. And it's fine, but it's better. I did this because I wanted you to see, when you go in the grocery store again next time, look at this. This is just 100% maple syrup versus pancake syrup, which has a bunch of high fructose corn syrup, which is really bad for you. So if you've never had, you probably all have had maple syrup in your life. Okay. But stay away from that high fructose corn syrup.
How much do you use of the syrup?
You just put it on, I don't know.
Okay. I don't know if you had like a measurement or.
Yeah, no. But ideally, the fruit sauce was supposed to take the place of syrup for those who wanted. But if you want to try the waffle with by itself, so you can know what it tastes like, or with the maple syrup, or if you want to try it with a scoop of healthy ice cream, we can do that too.
Can I just say one more thing about this? Now, some people like they like waffles very crispy. With bananas, this is not going to be a crispy waffle, okay? I'm going to break it to you. This is not a crispy waffle, okay? Now, if you want a little bit more of a crispiness with a banana, then you can alternate spraying every other time. So spray the first time. Don't spray the second time. It'll be a little bit more thick. You can let it stay in the waffle iron a little bit longer as well. If you really want that type of texture, take the bananas out and just use the oats, okay? And the oats by itself, you won't have to be in the waffle iron as long, and it will be a little bit more firm.
Okay. So. And also, if you warm them up, like if you freeze and warm them up in the oven, won't that be nice and crispy too?
It can be, yeah. You can have put in like a toaster oven or something like that.
I've gotten your waffles and put them in the oven and it's crispy.
And how much time do we have?
Three more, well, probably 2 more minutes.
Okay. Well, we don't have to wait for this.
Yeah,
so.
Come on, guys, help yourselves.
That's it.
Does anybody want a scoop of ice cream on their plates, or do you want to wait until you're done with the waffle? Okay, guys, it's ice cream right? Substitute. Okay, not ice cream.
It's nice cream.
It's frozen dessert.
Frozen creamy dessert.
Sounds good to me. I like ice cream.
Is that the white stuff
that's right there?
It's
just a... Now remember, it's got all that. It's got fiber because it's the cashew. All this stuff, remember we went over that? I went over based on the ingredients. So, plenty of fiber in your diet today.
That's a
good
one.
Really so, good. What did you suggest?
Oh, they have like a nice, lightly salted popcorn. It's just popcorn. I think sunflower oil and salt. Yum.